your cheers. Welcome to another day of USWA Championship Wrestling. I'm Dave Brown here at ringside, joined today by Michael St. John. Thanks for filling in for me last week.
Really enjoyed it, Dave. It's good being here with you this time around.
Good to have you back. Who's on the show today?
Boy, we got a big card lined up. We have the USWA Unified Heavyweight Champion. The Snowman will be in action. We also have the USWA World Tag Team Champions that will be defending their belts right here on television. I'm talking about Rex King and Joey Maggs. And a whole lot more. I mean, we've got an action-packed lineup today on Championship Wrestling.
Plenty of action coming up, including Brian Lee and Don Harris as a tag team. Many of you wrestling fans will remember both of them. Well, you'll see them here in our opening match when we come back and get this action underway in just a moment. Stay with us. We are right here at ringside, and in the ring right now, a couple of new faces, Tim Dixon and Brian Starr. They are set to go against Brian Lee, primetime Brian Lee, and Don Harris, who should be headed this way just any time.
Dave, a little bit of background on Tim Dixon and Brian Starr out of Indianapolis, Indiana, and mm-hmm. come here highly regarded, but they'll have a stern test today. Lee and Harris have made one heck of a tag team.
Well, here they come with a little assistance on their way up to the ring.
What do you think? Who looks better, me or the girl? I'm just about as good looking, don't you think?
No, I don't. There's no contest, Brian Lee. Who looks best? The young lady by far looks much better than you do, but climb on into the ring there. Let's get this tag team action underway. One fall, 10-minute time limit. Jerry Calhoun's going to be the referee. Some brief instructions to both teams. They've heard it all before. Let's see if Brian Lee and Don Harris pay attention to it. And here we go. One at a time, please, the referee says to start. They both started over to the corner there.
Sort of hard keeping your eye on the ring with the distractions outside the ring, Dave.
That's true. Yeah, their valet has left the ring area. Now it's just Don Harris in there right now. Boy, I tell you what, Tim Dixon and Brian Starr have their work cut out for them. These are not only a couple of tough veteran wrestlers, they are big. They don't carry an overabundance of weight, if you know what I mean, but they are tall and they are solidly built. Talking about Brian Lee and Don Harris.
Well proportioned in their speed in the ring. The agility and speed of the ring of this tag team is very, very strong.
It's the kind of tag team that you can see as world champions. What we don't like to see is some of the tactics they're using. For instance, there's no reason for Brian Lee to pound it back in the corner. There's a boot to the face coming off of there. It's the bottom of the boot, and it's, believe it or not illegal.
Brian and Don will resort to just about anything it takes to win a match, and they like to take care of business quickly. I mean, they go right to work.
That's true, and it's unfortunate they'll resort to anything because, as we say, they could win a match. They're a talented team, but we'll see what happens as things go along here. So far, the team from Indianapolis has had a long day, and they've only been wrestling about a minute or so.
Made in the corner. We'll see Brian Starr this time enter the ring, and boy, that's not a very auspicious way to enter the ring.
Boy, you're absolutely right. Mr. Starr, welcome to Championship Wrestling, but what a tough way to come in here. Head into the turnbuckle, he bounces out of the corner, and right there, Mr. Harris picks him up, throws him through the rope, down onto the floor.
Now we see the double teaming coming into being right here. Brian Lee dropping down to the floor. Look at that. Body slammed him right on the floor.
Brian Lee working on him unnecessarily outside while Don Harris was keeping the referee distracted across the way. Starr rolled back into the ring. Don Harris grabs him off the rope with a clothesline. You know, that was half a clothesline and half a choke. He held on for a long time there. Didn't just pop him and let go. He almost rode down to the mat with him with that close line.
Starr's out on his feet. I mean, they are just no match for the team of Brian Lee and Don Harris.
This size is something else, and as you mentioned, the speed, you put them together, you've got yourself a tough tag team. There's a power slam. Not the best power slam I ever saw, but it didn't matter because it was effective, and that's the bottom line. Look at this, coming off the top rope, Brian Lee drops down on him. There's a cover, count of one, two, and it's over.
He got him. Brian Lee almost almost was in the lights that time coming off the top rope.
So. You're right. Off that top rope, and with the height he has, he just barely missed a couple of the lights up there. The time on it, 2 minutes, 23 seconds. And as you mentioned, they don't like to waste a lot of time. They just come in and take care of business. Oh, look at this. Brian Lee over to insult the snowman. I don't know exactly what's being said. Can't hear from him. Oh, a little shoving match. Referee in between. Is that a security guard in the neighborhood? You might want to keep him there.
Oh, that's cool.
And, yeah, let's see.
Somebody out here to separate this.
Brian Lee and the snowman. Kind of continuing an earlier disagreement. And now Jerry Calhoun, the referee, is trying to step in between them. He's in between three of them. All right, here comes some more help. Mr. Coffey and Mr. Guy Coffey out with additional security, and we need to get that broken up. We don't need that going on here.
Dave, that's right there in the crowd. That could be very
dangerous. Yeah, we don't want that anywhere around the crowd over there at all. It's time, place for that's in the ring. Brian Lee picking up the referee. Snowman trying to fight past the security guard, too. And, hang on to Snowman.
Snowman's got a short fuse, Dave.
Yeah, well.
And I don't blame him in this case.
Especially with what's been going on with Brian Lee, too. And there's a challenge by Brian Lee. Snowman didn't back up an inch. I don't think you'll see him back up an inch. There he is, escorted back to his seat. You know, he sits in the audience over here before his scheduled match or interview of the day. And he does have a match schedule coming up, as a matter of fact. And
he likes to be called a people's champion, and he sits with the people.
He sits with the people. We'll take a break. We'll be back, and we'll have that match with Snowman when we return. Hey, here we are right here, ready to go with the next match. Snowman now making his way up to the ring. He's got that unified world championship belt slung over his shoulder, and he is not defending it today. This is a non-title match, but Snowman up there and looking to get himself a victory as he continues his championship reign. A lot of people surprised when Snowman won the belt, and I got to tell you, I was one of them. Here, coming into the ring right now, escorted by one of the USWA ring girls, is Dan Garza. Dan Garza, our first look at him. We don't know too much about him, but he is climbing in against the snowman. I can tell you just by looking that Garza's given away considerable weight. And we also know that he's given away a lot of experience to the snowman.
Snowman going right in after him too, Dave. The snowman knows exactly what you just said and going right to him with the bite.
Big power broad arm, follow it up with a clothesline, pick him up, maybe pulling a little hair. Snowman, yelling and screaming at him. Snowman came ready to do battle today. Big right hand knocks Garza down to the mat. Dan Garza, first look at him on USWA Championship Wrestling. My goodness gracious.
Could be it.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to get up from that one. Three, he does not get up from it. The count is three, and the snowman, and can you believe this? 36 seconds has just won this match. Throws Garza into the ropes, rolls him out of the ring, and there he goes.
I think that little altercation earlier with the snowman had him riled up for this match. And, of course, he took that fight right to Garza and made short work of him.
I think you're exactly right. Brian Lee out here challenging the snowman. I tell you what, Snowman, come on over for an interview after, I know it didn't take too long, but catch your breath just for a minute. I want to show everyone some videotape, Michael, from what happened in Memphis, Tennessee at the Mid-South Coliseum involving the snowman and Brian Lee. Then we'll talk to Snowman when we come back. Take a look.
Man. The unified world champ trying hard in there to hang on to it. Snowman was just tripped by Don Harris, who has just come out to ringside. Brian Lee was in trouble. He went to the back, said, "Come on, Don, come out there, give me some help." Frank Morrell saying, "What are you doing out here, guy?" He's out here to help double team Snowman. Brian Lee putting a big boot to the back of the world unified heavyweight champion. And it looked like Snowman had things well under control until Don Harris got involved.
Prime time fires Snowman off. Snowman ducks the clothesline. Snowman catches him with a right. time down to his knees now. The world champion looking really good in there against Prime Time. But look at this. Don Harris gets up on the ring apron. Starts looking over the snowman. Referee Frank Morrell calling for the bell to be rung. As now they're in here double teaming. Prime Time, Brian Lee and Don Harris are in here going after the world champ.
They fire him off into the rope. Double clothesline. And here comes Jeff Jarrett.
Well, there it was right there. You were being double teamed throughout all of that, but Jeff Jarrett comes in to help out.
You know, everybody's coming at this belt, and they're coming in two, threes. But, you know, I still kind of feel shaky about the USWA until I spotted Jeff Jarrett. Jeff Jarrett come in and gave me a big hand. I can't believe it, so I want to thank him for all his moral support coming to the rescue. But this guy, I can't believe he would go to the dressing room and get someone else. He come out here in the crowd, I'm the people champion, messing with me.
You see what I'm saying, Dave Brown?
Come on now. You
understand what I'm saying,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I do. This is not your time.
It is. Hey, Dave Brown, how come when he has someone jump in the ring like Jeff Jarrett, he's out here laughing and putting it over, isn't he? My brother helps me out because Jeff hits the ring and all these idiots out here saw what happened. 2-on-1, Dave. You saw it. 2-on-1.
Yeah, it was you two against him. We saw what happened on the video.
Jeff Jarrett and him against myself. Any day this punk wants to get in the ring 1-on-1 and put the title on the line, we'll do it.
What did you say, brother?
He said, anytime you want to get on the ring one-on-one and put the title on the line,
anytime you want to get on the ring.
Wait a minute.
Now, look. You want to talk? Talk.
You won't tell
what
me
you guys, what you guys better do is better head for the border, Louise. That's what you look like to me.
Huh?
Better head for the border. Hold on. I'm telling you. Let me tell you something. It's all right. This week, punk, I got your number. And let me tell you something, boy, you better get your bunk bed and keep it with you. I'm going to put you to sleep, punk. This week.
You see it? It's Jeff Jarrett or it's a chair. You be in the ring Monday, punk, I'll kick your butt.
Ain't nothing you going to kick. That's all right, brother. I got it together right in USWA, punk.
Brian Lee, Don Harris finally getting out of here. Snowman, I'm sorry they came out and interfered. We'll be back with more USWA action in just a moment. Few weeks, we have seen baseball and softball bats used for, shall we say, other than their intended purpose.
Well, it's the
here.
Right season, but it's not exactly being used in the right atmosphere. I'll tell you, when Jerry the King Lawler and Bill Dundee and Tony Anthony and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert all get after each other, goodness knows what can happen.
Boy, you're exactly right. And a few days ago, boy, there was one of the wildest matches you have ever seen. The bats came into play, and take a look at what happened.
And Tom Burton.
Well, they got started fast in this Texas death match. We've seen Lawler and Dundee use those baseball bats before. Lawler sets White Boy into the rope and hits a home run right across his midsection. Lawler down for a cover. Count of three, and this first ball is over. Lawler and Dundee in very quick fashion have won the first Texas death match. Fire, 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 fire.
half. Sends him straight up in the air and just drives that head right down into the mat. Eddie Gilbert in, breaks the paint cover. With an elbow to the back of the head of Lawler, but Dundee in here catches Gilbert, sends him outside on the apron.
Now Dirty White Boy fires away one on Lawler. Gilbert has one of the power cables here at ringside, has it wrapped around Lawler's throat, trying to choke him.
Eddie Gilbert back up in there with Lawler, really working him over, working on that head injury.
Gilbert looking around the ring, climbing outside. He's got a wild look in his eyes. He's up to the top rope, Lawler in the center of the ring, and a fist drop from Gilbert, and he goes for the cover. Count of one, count of two, count of three, and this ball is over. Lawler trying to make his way back over. Gilbert stops him. Gilbert himself is bloody now at this point. This thing is quickly turning into a bloodbath.
Lawler trying hard now to hang on. Trying to hang tough in there. As Gilbert continues to work on that busted head of Lawler's. But Lawler reaching down deep inside now. Puts Gilbert off of his feet. Lawler really working him over. And the King with a tag on the superstar. Dundee coming in. Goes after both the Dirty White Boy and hot stuff Eddie Gilbert. Dundee going for the pin cover. One, two, three.
Gilbert puts the pile driver on Dundee. Both men down. Neither one got up. I'm not sure what they're going to do in this case. Calhoun says there's got to be a winner. The first man to his feet is going to win this match.
Shape. Referee Jerry Calhoun says the first man to his feet will win. There has to be a winner of the fall. The crowd, 110% behind the superstar. Dundee, halfway up. Tony Anthony back down. But the superstar makes it up to his feet. Of the match, Jerry the King Lawler and Bill Superstar Dundee.
Calhoun is on handcuffing Tessa, and she's gonna get to have a little payback on the Dirty White Girl. White Girl is saying, please, somebody get me out of this. Here comes Tessa, and when you look at that look in her eyes,
Tessa's already saying she's going to get a taste of what it was all about last week when the White Girl humiliated Tessa. After the match, Dundee unhandcuffing the Dirty White Girl. He shoves her on up into the ring. Jerry Calhoun tells her she's going to have to get over there. The White Girl. Look at this. Dundee's got the cuffs now, putting them back on the White Girl, and handcuffs her to the top rope where she can't get away. As Lawler and Dundee hold Gilbert and the White Boy at bay. There goes Tessa. Starts ripping the dress right off the Dirty White Girl.
And here comes the Dirty White Boy. He's got Tessa by the hair. Slugs Dundee. Is holding Tessa. Gilbert's got the keys to the handcuffs. They're going to let Dirty White Girl loose. No, man, not this. We saw this last time. They'll do anything. Now they're handcuffing Tessa. Man, Dundee and Lawler need to stop this. Lawler up on Gilbert, and here goes Dirty White Girl right back on Tessa. Tessa, by all right, won this match. She shouldn't be having to undergo this humiliation again this week. And Dundee beaten in the center of the ring. White girl trying to rip Tessa's blouse off. And now Tony Anthony has the baseball bat. Man, somebody ought to stop these guys.
Look at this, the white boy just nailed Tom Burton. Lawler grabs the bat and goes after Gilbert. As the white girl and Tessa are still getting into it. Look at this. Lawler in there at that bat about to level the white girl. Tony Anthony in there saves her just barely. As the action continues to be wild. Tony Anthony works Dundee over with that baseball bat. Jeff Jarrett in here. Gonna lend a hand. Now Tom Burton gets him out of the ring.
Just incredible action of all different kinds there going on.
I mean, it's so hard for the camera even to follow. It's going on all over the place.
Hey, what's coming in right here with two baseball bats in hand? The king himself headed this way. And not one, but two bats as he heads over in this direction. Go to pose. Somebody in the crowd here has a Jerry the King Lawler shirt on. Kind of a matching set there with the shirts with the king. And there he comes with two bats.
Well, I got a couple of bats for a couple of reasons. We're going to be talking about some things that are going to be coming up. One, of course, this is going to be this big return. Now, this is a return match. I don't know if you've told the people all the stipulations. There are a little bit different stipulations this week on this match. But I wish that Bill Dundee and Tessa were here today so that they could tell you about this match themselves. But they're in Texas again. But they did send a videotape interview, and I want to go ahead, if you would, go ahead and play this interview and listen to Tessa, because she's got a few things that she wanted to get across to the dirty white girl. And then I got some other things I'd like to say too.
Here's that tape.
Oh man. Tony Anthony and the Dirty White Boys and Eddie Gilbert and you, little dirty white girl. Oh, I'm not going to say that you ain't good athletes and you're not tough, because you are. Because it took us about half hour to beat you up the last time we saw you in the ring. But let me tell you something. Every time we whooped you, you had a little old guy running from the outside. He's not so little. His name's Tom Burton, and he was the factor, brother. He was the big gun that came sneaking in from behind. Well, this week that ain't going to happen. Because he's going to be handcuffed to the turnbuckle. I don't know where they're going to put it. I think it's around his feet. They're going to shackle him to the turnbuckle. And then they're going to put one hand on Tessa and one on the dirty white girl. And they're going to be handcuffed to you, brother. So you ain't going to go nowhere. And with them shackles around your feet, you're not going to be able to hit Tessa. So we're going to have to worry about that. But once we beat up them boys, it's a Texas death match, bunkhouse rules. That means we're all in the ring, all four at one time. And anything can happen there. But the bottom line that's going to happen is one of you is not going to answer the bell. And then when that happens, oh, mercy, Miss Tessie, you're going to get to do what?
Dirty white girl, Tom Burton has always been the factor that has kept me from doing exactly what I wanted to do to you. But this week when Dundee and Lawler beat the dirty white boys, let me tell you what I'm going to do. You are going to be shackled, and so is Tom Burton, and I'm going to rip every stitch of your clothing off like that should have happened a long, long time ago. And Tom Burton, you're not going to be able to do anything about it.
That's right, baby. So just let me tell you this, boys and girls. We're going to show everybody in that Coliseum and that building just exactly how much of a woman you are, girl.
Well, there they are from Texas.
Yeah, well, you see, now I think they pretty well explained most of those stipulations. The interesting thing is this. The last week, you had Tom Burton handcuffed to one turnbuckle in a neutral corner. You had the dirty white girl handcuffed to the corner of Eddie Gilbert and Dirty White Boy. And you had Tessa handcuffed in our corner. But this week, it's going to be one little interesting difference. This week, they're going to take, you ever seen those leg shackles that they put on people? It's sort of like handcuffs that go around their ankles and make sure they can't run very far or very fast. Well, what they're going to do, they're going to set Tom Burton down in one corner, and they're going to put a set of those shackles on his right ankle, and then they're going to run that chain past the ring post now. They're going to run it around the ring post, and then they're going to chain his left ankle. So all he's going to be able to do is sit quietly in that chair. He's not even going to be able to stand up, and he's not going to be able to move one inch. But then what makes it real interesting is they're going to take his right hand, and they're going to handcuff the dirty white girl to him. And then they're going to take his left hand, and they're going to handcuff Tessa to him. And what makes that real interesting is you're looking at two girls that really want to kill each other, and Tom Burton is going to be stuck right in the middle. So let me tell you something, pal. You've interfered for the last time, I can assure you of this. And then the match itself is going to take place, Dundee and myself against Eddie Gilbert and Tony Anthony. And as he said, it's a Texas Tornado death match. That means the falls don't count. You can pin somebody all night long, but they have to go. You have to keep on going until somebody is not able to answer the bell. And like Dundee said, it took a while last time. It may take a while this time, but we plan to keep this thing going. Yeah, hey, come on out here, boys. Come on out.
Hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert and Tony Anthony.
Yeah, we know that he's right back here somewhere. We're not falling out again, Lawler.
No, come on out, guys. Come on. Come on out. I'd like to invite you out here personally right now.
They don't believe Dundee and Tessa are in Texas, apparently.
Well, let me just say this. Oh, I see, because I got two bats. They happen to think that Bill Dundee is waiting in the back for him back there again, right?
He is.
Come on, guys. Come on out and see if he is. Well, let me just say this. The different stipulation is the fact that all four men are going to be in the ring at the same time. They're not going to stop the match. I don't care if somebody's bleeding from head to toe. I don't care if bones are broken. I don't care what happens. They don't stop this until somebody can't answer the bell. And Eddie Gilbert and Tony Anthony, when one of the two of you jerks are unable... Come on. Well, when one of the two of you jerks are unable to answer the bell, then we unhandcuff Tessa. And I promise you, last week, the job didn't get done, but just like they said, Tony Anthony, you and the dirty white girl, she likes to strut her stuff and she likes to try to tease everybody. Well, this week, I can promise you, I can assure you that everybody is going to get to see, like Dundee said, just what kind of girl the dirty white girl really is. We're going to see for ourselves, and so is everybody down there, because Tessa has assured us that she will, without a doubt, rip every stitch of clothes that she's got on off Monday night. So come on down there. Come on out here now, guys. Go ahead. All right, I'll tell you what. I'll go. You come on out.
All right, well, they're not coming out. They think Dundee is going to come out and Jerry's going to hand them the bat or something, and they don't want to deal with that, obviously. So Jerry says, I'm out of here, and we do have an interview scheduled with Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Tony Anthony, the Dirty White Boys. There's the King posing for a picture on the way out for Sam Lowe.
I think Anthony and Gilbert are actually afraid of this situation.
Yeah, well, and you know,
well, they
with
got
pretty
burned.
Good reason.
They got burned, literally.
With those baseball bats, that does kind of give the King an extra advantage. Yeah, he's gone. Well, wait there. He's kind of back here. Lawler's still hanging around over close to the door. Now he heads back
Dundee,
to the dressing area.
Paul, let's check under here and see if he's under here.
He's not here. He's in Texas, Eddie.
Are you sure? He could be standing right now. We have plenty of room. You know, there's a lot of things being said about Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert in wrestling right now. Some good, some bad, all interesting.
Hey, wait a minute. You over there, come here.
I just saw this guy out here
on,
taking
now, leave
pictures.
Leave him alone.
I just saw this guy taking pictures of Jerry. Oh, he took a picture of me and one of my fans the other week, didn't he, Dave? You come here. Sam, Sam, what's your name? Yeah, come on.
Sam Lowe. Come on, leave
here.
Sam alone.
Here, Sam.
Sam, watch him now.
Here, Sam. To be afraid of.
Yeah, okay.
I was just noticing something there. Sam
Lowe.
Lost? Lowe?
Lowe.
Sam Lowe. Take pictures, do you?
Yes.
Every week. I see you at the matches. I see you here every Saturday. You were just taking some interesting pictures of Jerry Lawler over there, so I guess you have his face on that film right there, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Do you like Jerry Lawler or something? Is he one of your favorites or something, Sam Lowe? Do you play on his ball team or something, Sam Lowe?
Well, no, I'm not on the ball team.
For
anything,
photographer, maybe.
We work together quite a bit.
You work together quite a bit. So I want to tell you something. Whenever you take pictures of Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, Tony Anthony, and Tom Burton, and the Dirty White Girl, we don't want our faces on the same roll of film with that ugly mutt, Jerry Lawler.
Come on.
You understand?
Hey.
No, you be quiet. You understand? Just a second, boy.
This is hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert, talking to you here.
To
when you take pictures of me or Tony Anthony or Tom Burton, you leave Jerry Lawler's face out of it. As a matter of fact.
No, we're not going to do this.
Come on, now, Eddie.
It's my camera now.
No, it's
yes, right. It is.
No,
my camera now. No, my camera.
No.
My camera.
You ain't going to touch
it. What's wrong? You want
again?
Your camera back or something?
Oh, guys. Tony, he wants his camera back.
He
wants
his camera back.
Yeah, we'll get
it.
Look at Tony. No.
Tony Anthony, good grief.
How does he like his coffee? Hot! He likes his coffee hot!
A little cream and sugar, maybe?
Well, it's time to get down to business, people. Hot stuff Eddie Gilbert came back here 3 weeks ago, and everybody said, why is he back in the USWA? What is the problem? He gave up a six-figure salary.
Shut up!
He gave up a six-figure salary to come back to the USWA. And what is he after? Well, I'm having a little problem here, people. It doesn't matter how much blood I draw out of Jerry Lawler's head or how much I emulate Bill Dundee in front of his woman. Jerry Lawler, the reason why I'm back here today is for you to pass the torch to Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, just like Jackie Fargo passed it to you, and I wish Jackie Fargo was here today. First, so I could punch him right in the mouth. Second, so he could tell you, Jerry Lawler, it's Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert's day. And everything I learned about brawling, I'm going to do this week in the Texas Tornado of Death. Anything goes, buck-ass rules. We're coming in the ring with anything. And then they're going to take Tom Burton, and they're going to handcuff each wrist to one of the girls that rings.
Eddie. I don't know about these two girls don't like each other, and I don't want to get involved with this. They're going to have
my idea. What's my idea at all?
Tony,
take a good
Tony, I always get something, but face get hurt.
Look what she's going to be.
Huh?
Look there. Look there. Look.
That's
what camera? Don't,
right
don't worry about
that's
it.
That's our dirty
hey,
right
hey,
there.
Hey. Don't listen, worry about it, brother. All right? Just take a look at
it. It's the blonde bimbo.
It's the blonde bimbo. Get in the way. Give her a headbutt.
Can I get her a headbutt?
Give her a headbutt.
Come on, Tony. I don't know if I want to do
it. Come on. I want the camera on. Show me. Hey, director. Where's the director at? Okay. Come here. Get a real close-up right here, baby. Come on. Bring the camera in tight.
Get it over here.
I don't want
on here? No, this one's on. Hey, come on. I said give me a close-up, and I mean now, of this picture right here. Come on. Take a good look. Everybody take a good look at what a real woman is all about, baby. Could you imagine Tessa in something like this? Be kind of horrifying, wouldn't it? Okay, we're going to put that up because that's enough of that. Now, superstar Bill Dundee, you runchy was out here running your mouth because you didn't have, on camera, you didn't have enough guts to show up today. And you too, Jerry the King Lawler, you come out with the ball bat. Well, that's fine and dandy, brother, because, what is it, a Texas death match?
Texas tornado rules and a bunkhouse match.
And a bunkhouse, that means, brother, wear whatever you want, bring whatever you want, because maybe me and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, which has got a new camera now, is going to get mean and nasty, and we'll bust their stinking skulls, whether you like it or not. We're walking out the winners, and Tessa, you'll not touch one hair on the dirty white girl.
Well, there they go, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, Tony Anthony, the Dirty White Boy, and Tom Burton. You've heard the stipulations, and they can come out here and they can throw coffee in the face of one of the photographers, but they're going to have a different situation when they step in there against Lawler and his partner, Bill Dundee, in the action that's coming up. We'll be back here in a moment. Cool 101 back with us, special ring announcer at the Mid-South Coliseum on Monday nights. And what are some of the special things going on for the fans this week?
Well, Dave, I tell you, this Monday night is July Jam at the Mid-South Coliseum. We're going to be giving away a lot of good prizes. Plus, we're going to have the second week, the semifinals of the Mr. Hardbody contest this Monday night just for the ladies. And the big grand prize, we got Ernie Barresso from Ernie Barresso Junkets here and Sharon Abens from Pyramid Travel. We're giving away a big trip getaway this weekend. Where are we going Monday night?
We're going to Atlantic City. We got a free trip for two, and it's all the airfare and all the gambling and all the fun you can have for 30 straight hours in Atlantic City.
No purchase necessary. You come on down on Monday night, and, hey, it's a big night of action.
That's going to be a big night down there. Bundy the Gorilla's got something special going on, I think, in the family section, don't you, Monday night?
Hey, man, we're going to be giving away prizes of all kind. We're going to be giving away Frisbees. And also, we're going to be giving, I'm going to be giving away to women the free kisses.
All right.
We've also got the USWA Ring Girls Monday night, too.
Hey, yes, indeed. There are some of the guys in the hard body competition. I understand there were about 18 of them last week. They selected two finalists, and there'll be more coming up this week.
That's exactly right.
Let me tell you what's coming up Monday night. 8 o'clock is wrestling time at the Memphis Mid-South Coliseum, and you be there on time because the opening match is going to be Joy Maggs going against Tom Burton in the opener of the night. Rex King takes on Don Harris in yet another single match. Then a $5,000 challenge match. More about this one later on. Cowabunga will be going against Wild Thing Jeff Gaylord. Then it'll be a match in which it'll be the hair versus the mask. Jeff Jarrett's hair against Mr. Devastation's mask. Reggie B. Fine will be in Mr. Devastation's corner. Return unified world heavyweight match as the Snowman with Jeff Jarrett in his corner. Now, the Snowman was telling me that he really appreciated, you heard him say that Jeff came in and gave him the support last week, and he was telling me that Jeff has indeed agreed to be in his corner Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum as he goes against the challenger, primetime Brian Lee, with Don Harris in his corner. So that's the return unified world match coming up Monday night, but not the main event, not the final match of the night. It's a main event anywhere, but not the final match. This is the final match of the night, and get ready for it. As if it hasn't been wild enough in the past couple of weeks, this time it's going to be a Texas Tornado death match. And as Jerry Lawler said a little bit earlier, that means that falls don't count. They continue until someone on one of the teams cannot answer the bell, and then the other team is going to be declared the winner. Also, it's bunkhouse rules, which means all four of them are going to be in the ring at one time. Who are we talking about? Well, we're talking about Jerry the King Lawler and Bill Dundee on one side of the ring. Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony on the other side of the ring. And remember the extra stipulations on that. Tessa and Dirty White Girl will be handcuffed to Tom Burton, and Burton will be shackled to the ring so he can't run around all over the building, too. Should make for a most interesting situation Monday night, all beginning at 8 o'clock at the Memphis Mid-South Coliseum. We certainly hope to see you there. Promises to be a full night of action. You can pick up your tickets until 5 o'clock this afternoon at the Coliseum and all day on Monday and at all the Ticketmaster locations that you see right here. One of the participants Monday night is going to be none other than Jeff Jarrett. Now, Jeff has had some interesting situations going on. Let's take a listen to this special thing from Jeff Jarrett right here.
You know, Akbar and Devastation Incorporated, you guys never cease to amaze me. Because when they came to me and they wanted to sign this match for Monday night, it was your guy, Akbar, is it Mr. Devastation, as you want to call him. It was his mask against my hair. Now, the people in Memphis, they've never seen this guy, never heard of him, so who cares about his stinking mask? But there's one thing that I wanted to add to the contract, and that the only way that I would sign this match is, if I win this match, I get $5,000. Now, Akbar, I know how your guys operate, and I know how they want to do their doings. They never do it one-on-one. They want to do it two-on-one, three-on-one, or even four-on-one. Well, you guys just better get ready, because I got friends, too, and they're going to be watching my back. And I'm going to unmask this guy in front of all the fans right there at the Mid-South Coliseum, and I'm going to have my hair. And I'm also going to have $5,000. And, you know, talking about friends, you know, I'm doing double duty Monday night, and I couldn't be more happier. Because, Snowman, you are the world unified heavyweight champion, and you're going to stay that way Monday night because I'm going to be in your corner, and I don't care if Don Harris or the Dirty White Boys or whoever tries to jump in the ring. Snowman, you're coming out on top, and I'll see you Monday night.
Well, you heard it from Jeff, $5,000 also into that, in addition to the hair versus mask stipulations in that match. Monday night, Mid-South Coliseum, 8 o'clock, Bundy the Gorilla, USWA Ring Girls, Hard Bodies Competition, prizes and giveaways, and great wrestling action. Back here in a moment. One of the lovely USWA ring girls has escorted Keith Goldsby into the ring, and he is there right now waiting for his opponent, Mr. Devastation, to show up. Devastation will be coming in with his manager in his corner, Reggie B. Fine.
You know, Dave, Mr. Devastation has been sent here as part of Devastation Incorporated, which is Skandar Akbar's army. Mm-hmm. And apparently Reggie B. Fine is now, for some reason, associated with that situation.
Indeed. He is going to be in the corner. There is Mr. Devastation. Boy, I tell you what, when it comes to size, Devastation has a strong advantage over Keith Goldsby, his opponent, as he steps in there. Gary Calhoun says, let's get this one going. Reggie B. Fine with that walking stick, which has figured in more than one match from time to time, over in the corner.
Mr. Devastation, sort of a mercenary, here for one intent purpose, and that is to get rid of, if you would, Jeff Jarrett.
That's right. And the action coming up. I think Jeff had an interesting point. It's going to be hair versus mask. Jeff cares a lot about his hair, and so do most of his fans around here. But I don't know how much interest there is in unmasking Mr. Devastation. I don't know. Would we know who he is when he takes a mask off? Who knows? But there's an additional stipulation as a result of that, $5,000. So not only does Devastation have to take the mask off, he and Reggie B. Fine are going to have to pay $5,000 to Mr. Jarrett when he wins the match, if he wins the match.
One of two things is going to happen. Either A, the fur is going to fly Monday night at the Mid-South Coliseum, mm-hmm. if you can excuse the pun, or Jeff Jarrett is going to have the opportunity to, number one, see who Skandar Akbar has sent to get after him, and number two, take some money away.
Count of three, and it's all over. Mr. Devastation has just defeated Keith Goldsby. Keith really never had much of a chance, as I got to say one thing. Whoever it is beneath that mask is powerful. No, well, Reggie B. Fine wants to say a word or two. All right, Reggie, we'll give you an opportunity to say a word or two. The man with the mask may be losing it come Monday night.
Losing it? Look, this is Mr. Devastation, baby. We came down here for one reason, and one reason only, to collect that bounty they got on their sister, Jessica Jerry. You see what I'm saying? We came down here for one reason, baby. And I know, see, me and Akbar go back a little bit, you know. Akbar, he came to me and told me, he said, look, I got somebody I want you to take and whoop that punk, Jeff Jarrett, and what? Save his head. I hope all you little pimple-faced low-budgets got a picture of that punk with them long locks on his head, because this going to be the last time y'all see it. So we're going to take that little pretty face and smush it and mush it, and then we're going to cut his hair off. Yeah. I mean, cut it all off, baby. He's going to look like a potato when he wake up in the morning.
I hear what you're saying. You got to remember, too, though, that you got $5,000 on the line. If you lose, you got to pay Jeff $5,000.
$5,000?
$5,000.
I don't mind paying no money. I'll put more than $5,000. I'll put $10,000 if I have to on this man right here. Because you look at this. Hey, man, show on them 35-inch biceps, baby. Look at that. Look at that. Like I said, we came here for one reason, and that's to demolish that punk Jessica Jerry. And we're going to do that come Monday night, because I need money, and this man needs money.
Right, baby.
You see what I'm saying? Because we like the finer things in life, baby. I got a 1991 Lincoln out there I got to pay for, and this man going to pay for it for me.
Well, you better do it Monday night right there in the middle of the ring. Reggie B. Fine, Mr. Devastation, sent in here by Skandar Akbar. And as Michael St. John said, strictly with a mission to get rid of Jeff Jarrett. We'll see what happens Monday night at the Coliseum. We'll see what happens right here when we come back in a moment.
Hi, this is Jerry Lawler at ringside, watching my friend Catherine Swisher preparing for the campaign trail in a race for Chancellor of Chancery Court Part 1. Catherine Swisher is an experienced trial litigator and has been practicing in Shelby County for more than 10 years. Honesty, integrity, knowledgeable, effective. A champion for all the people. On August the 2nd, vote Catherine M. Swisher, Chancellor, Chancery Court, Part 1. Paid for by the committee to elect Catherine M. Swisher, Dr. E.E. Joe, Chairman.
There we go. going to be looking at Cowabunga right here in the ring in just a couple of minutes, so stay with us for that. That should be most interesting. Michael St. John, what about if folks want to have wrestling in their territory, or if they want to have appearances by wrestlers? What do they do?
Well, Dave, most exciting event you can possibly have is championship wrestling for your next event. Social organization, you've got to raise money. This is a great way to do it. And if you've got a company that's having a grand opening or an event that you want to publicize, championship marketing through championship wrestling, a great way to take care of business. 901-375-4044. Give championship marketing a call. If you get a busy signal, call back and book early because they book up quickly.
Exactly right. And I get calls from time to time, of course, that say, hey, how do I get in touch with the king? How do I get in touch with so-and-so? We'd like to have him make an appearance. Well, that was the number right there. Championship marketing, the place to call. They handle all the bookings, and they'll take care of you there. Let's take a look at some action coming up around the territory. We've already told you about that tremendous card we got at the Mid-South Coliseum on Monday night. What about tonight? Well, a couple of places having championship wrestling action. Osceola, Arkansas, tonight at 8 o'clock at the junior high school. You see the folks that are going to be there. Lawler, Dundee with Tessa. Dirty White Boy will be there. Dirty White Girl. Boy, Tessa and Dirty White Girl in the same building. That could be interesting tonight in Osceola, Arkansas. Then, also tonight, in Alamo, Tennessee, at the National Guard Armory in Alamo, Jeff Jarrett will be there. Eddie Gilbert, Cowabunga, ladies match. Tickets will go on sale today at 3 o'clock for the matches in Alamo, Tennessee, tonight at 8 o'clock. Also today, and I think maybe Jerry Lawler will have a little bit more to say about this a little bit later on, out at Airport Toyota, they're going to have special wrestling. Lawler, Snowman, Cowabunga, Jeff Gaylord will be there, Scott Braddock, Ken Wayne, all of them this afternoon at Airport Toyota. That is this afternoon at 3 o'clock. Coming up in Halls, Tennessee on Friday night, August 3rd, buy your tickets in advance and you save $1. You see, they're going to have tremendous talent in Halls, Tennessee on Friday night. Coming up on August 9th, and that'll be a Thursday night in Lawrenceburg, Tennessee at the Rotary Park Building. USWA Wrestling will be coming to town. And on August 10th, hey, my old hometown in Trenton, Tennessee at the National Guard Armory there, a stretcher match included on that card. Look at that. Lawler's scheduled to be there. Eddie Gilbert, Dirty White Boy, Snowman, Cowabunga. Tickets are on sale at the Armory. It's going to be Friday, August 10th in Trenton, Tennessee. And coming up on August the 12th, that's a Sunday, Jackson, Tennessee, as championship wrestling will be returning there. On August 17th in Boonville, Mississippi. August 25th in Jonesboro, Arkansas. And coming soon, championship wrestling in Senatobia, Mississippi, Forest City, Arkansas, and Kennett, Missouri. One more quick reminder as I see him headed this way. Jerry Lawler coming over here. The Jerry Lawler Show tomorrow morning at 11 o'clock right here on TV5. And here he is, baseball bat in hand.
Dave, I have the baseball bat again because I want to make a couple of big, well, one big special announcement to everybody. You didn't say anything about it yet, about the fact that, yeah, you're right, Airport Toyota. Of course, there are going to be matches this afternoon. At 3 o'clock at Airport Toyota, I'm going to be out there wrestling the Snowman, Cowabunga, Ken Wayne, Jeff Gaylord, Scott Braddock. Now, there are a lot of people that are sitting out there right now that probably never seen a wrestling match live. A lot of them are like you, Dave. They're too cheap to buy a ticket. But some people, though, this is your opportunity to get a chance to see some matches absolutely free, up real close. Come on out to Airport Toyota this afternoon at 3 o'clock. It's free, and not only that, I understand they're going to have tickets to Monday night's matches that they're going to be giving away out there, too.
Good.
So come on by 3 o'clock today, absolutely free. You'll see three big matches and be right up close to the action at Airport Toyota. Now, that's at Brooks Road and Mill Branch. So, also, I want to mention, too, I got a couple of personal appearances that I want to mention. Also, this afternoon at 1 o'clock, there's a benefit taking place down at the Caddy Shack. Now, you're familiar with where the Caddy Shack is. That's right down there at Goodman Road and Pleasant Hill Road in Olive Branch, Mississippi. It's just about 5 minutes outside of Memphis here. And it's a benefit for that young man that I had on my TV show last week. And his name is Daniel Miller, the little two-year-old boy that has cerebral palsy. And we're going to all be down there giving away some free wrestling tickets there. And they're having a big auction. There's music, all sorts of things. And I'm going to be there at 1 o'clock. In about 1 hour from right now, I will be down there at the Caddy Shack. And that's once again located at, what did I say?
Goodman Road and Pleasant Hill Road.
Goodman Road and Pleasant Hill. You're exactly right, in Olive Branch. Okay. Now, we got another big announcement. Are you ready for this? We've had this a couple of times in the past, and we just signed it yesterday. We're going to have it again Tuesday, August the 7th. Tuesday night at 8 p.m., August the 7th, out in Millington, Tennessee, where at the Legion Field, where they just had all the USA and Cuba Olympic baseball games. Well, you're going to see the good guys against the bad guys in a big softball game. That's right. We're going to play some ball out there. Plus, we're also going to have wrestling out there, too. There's going to be five matches five wrestling matches right there at home plate on the field. Then there's also going to be the big softball game. Listen to this lineup. How does this sound? Playing first base, Jerry the King Lawler. Playing second base, Bill Superstar Dundee. Playing shortstop, Jeff Jarrett. Playing third base, the Snowman. Playing catching, Cowabunga. Playing in the outfield, Rex King, Joey Maggs, Jerry Calhoun, plus and King Cobra. Now we're going to be going up against, listen to this bunch of jerks. Eddie Gilbert, Tony Anthony, Tom Burton, Jeff Gaylord, Scott Braddock, Brian Lee, the Galaxian, and Downtown Bruno. These guys think they can beat us in softball. Let me tell you something. I hit a ball so far Thursday night it hadn't come down yet, and I can guarantee you, I'm not only going to be hitting softballs, but you guys get in my way out there in Millington, we're going to be hitting a lot of other things. I play first base, and I can promise you this, Eddie Gilbert, Brian Lee, Tony Anthony, none of you are getting past first base. Do you understand what I'm talking about? I don't care what it takes. That's going to be Tuesday night at 8 o'clock, Legion Field in Millington, Tennessee. You can call out there and get more information. We'll tell you more about it next week, okay?
All right, Tuesday night the 7th.
And now one other thing, and I know I've been out here a long time, but I just want to mention, last night I went by Le Bonheur Hospital, and I paid a visit to a young man, a couple of brave young men, as a matter of fact. There was a young man who was involved in an accident. He was hit by a van. His name was Sam Hayes. He was hit by a van. He was 7 years old up in Somerville, Tennessee. And the family got in touch with me and asked me to come by and see the young man. Unfortunately, Sam passed away yesterday, and when I went by, I saw his family, and I saw his young brother named Jesse, and they told me that Sam was a great wrestling fan and the biggest King Lawler fan in the world. And I just want to say that my heart and my prayers go out to his family, and especially to his dad, Dennis, and his brother, Jesse. And it was great seeing him yesterday. And I know right now that Sam's watching the show, and we're going to dedicate this big match Monday night to Sam Hayes, okay?
Thanks. Okay. We'll be back. Cowabunga is going to be headed this way here in just a moment. I think Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle craze has spread worldwide here in the last few months. And
right over into the wrestling ring.
Indeed. Cowabunga is in here. And, you know, Ken Wayne coming this way, the U.S. Junior Heavyweight Champion. This is a non-title match. Ken steps up on the ring apron, through the ropes and into the ring. Referee Jerry Calhoun is in the ring.
Ken Wayne's a fine wrestler in his own right, but Cowabunga has really surprised me. You know, when it first started, I didn't know that he was going to be this good of a wrestler, but my goodness, he's really good in the ring.
You know, I think that's an excellent point, and I think probably most of us felt that way. We thought, okay, hey, here's a guy in a turtle outfit, but probably can't wrestle. But, boy, has he proven that as advertised in the beginning, we had heard that he was an expert in the martial arts. He is. He's into karate and all of that, and he can really move in the ring. And he's greeting the fans right now, turns toward the ring, up on the apron, through the ropes, and we are just about set to go with a one-fall, 10-minute time limit match, Cowabunga against Ken Wayne. And here we go.
This should be quite a match, Dave. And I'll tell you, Cowabunga, he may look green on TV, but when it comes to his wrestling skills, this young man, whoever's under that hood, who's ever in that costume, can really wrestle.
Handshake. Mutual respect there between Ken Wayne, the U.S. Junior Heavyweight Champion, and Cowabunga. Cowabunga drops into one of those, is that judo or karate? I must admit I'm not skilled enough to be able to tell which that is. I don't think it matters, maybe. I think the fact that he is skilled in that is what's the important part. Ken Wayne trying to come in at him, but there's some of the quickness right here. See him move back.
He is very, very quick in the ring. And a little bit later on the wrestling program today, Dave, I understand Cowabunga is going to give us a special karate demonstration. And I'm looking forward to seeing that because from what I've seen in the ring, it looks like the man is well mastered in the martial arts.
Should be interesting. Following the match, we'll try to get him over here for that demonstration. Nightmare Ken Wayne. Not too anxious to get too close to Cowabunga.
Oh, nice move by
that
Wayne.
That was a very good move by Ken Wayne. Excellent move.
Kim's a good wrestler in his own right. Of course, he wouldn't be the USWA's World Junior Heavyweight Champion, would he not be? And these two, you got two of the best wrestlers, as the sport goes, right here in the ring right now, here today on television.
Good move by Cowabunga there. Wayne had a good move, and Cowabunga proves that he can move in there, too, put his opponent on the mat. Ken Wayne looked to me like he was using a fist, Michael.
I think he may have. He looked like he was going to throw that forearm, but at the last minute, he changed his mind, I believe.
Small package by Cowabunga. Look at him rolling around the ring. Can either of them hold the shoulders of the other down for a count of three? Ken Wayne shoulders down three. He got it.
He got it.
He got it. Nice move by Cowabunga. That was one of those situations where either wrestler, if he could have gained a momentary advantage for a three count, would be the winner of the match. And Cowabunga got the three count on Ken Wayne.
I think Cowabunga just ended up hooking that other leg, and that kept Ken from the mobility of rolling in the ring, and he just wrapped it. Look at that.
I like to see that, too. There's a handshake after the match. Cowabunga comes up with a victory. The time on it, 2 minutes. 2 minutes even as Cowabunga gets the victory. And I don't know exactly what he has in mind.
Three.
He is over here.
Awesome.
Let me get some of this here. I don't know what you have in mind, but
hey,
I understand you got a little bit.
Hey, man. I know this is your interview time. I want to tell everybody, not only you, but all the people. A few weeks ago, I come out here, and I thought you were just another goof dressed up in a turtle suit. Well, you know, I didn't think too much about you. But I've seen you wrestle, and I've wrestled you. I'll be the first one to stick my hand out and say, brother, you're real good.
All right. Totally radical, awesome. Wrestling Ken Wayne, dude. All right. Nightmare. Let's break some boards, dude.
Okay, congratulations on the victory there. You're really excited the fans. Now, I don't know. We got a couple of, gallon cans of paint here. And, all right. Oh, I see. And now some boards here. I tell you what, you smacked that with that side of that hand and it popped. All right, here's one right here. All right, let's watch what happens here. Cowabunga. Ooh. All right. Want to break another one?
Hand went right through that board, Dave.
Hey, wait a minute now. Jeff Gaylord and Scott Braddock, the Wild Things in downtown Bruno. Look, we're out here with a demonstration. You guys
can't just... Let me tell you something! Shut up, you idiot! Hey, who are you trying to impress?
Hold up, dude.
These little boards, they can't fight back. Let me tell you something. If you want to impress somebody, this is impressive. Impressive, and as a matter of fact, when you get in the ring with me, brother, I'm going to hit you with so many lefts, you're going to be begging for a right. I want to show you something. Hey, Scott, help me out. Hold him.
Hey, come on. Bruno, for heaven's sake.
Who's this guy trying to impress out here?
What, coming out here, three against one. You over here and Gaylord and Scott Braddock. Breaking boards over Cowabunga's head and Bruno over with a boot kicking on him. Can we get him some help out here, please? Goodness, I tell you what. Here comes Ken Wayne out to help. Ken Wayne with a wooden stool there.
We better get some help over here, Dave.
Ken, thank you for coming out and helping out. Now, let's watch him. Let's get those guys out of here. Jeff Gaylord, oh boy, the Wild Things. Gaylord, Braddock, and downtown Bruno. All right, yeah, let's help him out of here. We'll take a break, we'll return.
Man,
Mad Wayne Bride join us once again. One more time, remind the folks of some of the great promotions coming up Monday night.
Monday night is July Jam at the Mid-South Coliseum. You want to be there for all the action. Plus, this week is a grand prize, a getaway trip to Atlantic City, New Jersey. Includes airfare, luxurious hotel accommodations at the Showboat Hotel and Casino. We've got other great prizes. The Mr. USWA Hard Body Contest, of course, the Ring Girls, and Bundy, the Family Fun Section. I'll be there. And Monday morning, I'll remind everybody that we got free wrestling tickets on Cool 101.
All right, very good. Bad Wayne Bright from Cool 101 will be at the Coliseum Monday night. Opening match of the night, 8 o'clock is when it all begins at the Mid-South Coliseum. And the opening match, Joey Maggs will be going against Tom Burton. Rex King, then, will be taking on Don Harris. Let's go to the, can we go to the opening match there Monday night at the Coliseum? Or do we not have the opening match Monday night at the Coliseum? Joey Maggs and Tom Burton, the opening match. Or do we not have the visuals? Okay, there we go. Monday night, 8 o'clock, Mid-South Coliseum. The opening match is Joey Maggs against Tom Burton. There we go. Rex King goes against Don Harris. And Guy Carvey, I've just been handed a change here, Wayne. It looks like instead of having separate matches here, it is going to be Cowabunga and Ken Wayne going against Jeff Gaylord and Scott Braddock with Downtown Bruno. So Ken Wayne and Cowabunga apparently have gotten it signed, and it was handed to me by a representative of the promotion. So I think we can count on that one being a tag team match. Once again, Cowabunga and Ken Wayne against Jeff Gaylord and Scott Braddock with Downtown Bruno. Like to see that one, especially considering what happened out here just a few minutes ago. Then, Hair going against The Mask and $5,000, Jeff Jarrett will be going against Mr. Devastation. Reggie B. Fine will be in Devastation's corner. They were sent in by Skandor Akbar. Then, return unified world heavyweight title match. The Snowman will bring that belt into the ring. He's going to have Jeff Jarrett in his corner this time, though. Primetime Brian Lee will be challenging for the belt. And, of course, he will have his partner, Don Harris, in the corner with him. It's a single match, but Don Harris in the corner, so Snowman says, hey, Jeff Jarrett has agreed to be in my corner, too. The unified world heavyweight belt will be on the line. Then, final match of the night, Texas Tornado Death Match rules. That means falls don't count. The match continues until one member of one of the teams cannot answer the bell, and the other team is declared the winner. In addition to that, it'll be bunkhouse rules, so it won't be a regular tag team match. All four of the men are going to be in the ring all at one time. Who's going to be in there? Well, it's going to be Jerry Lawler, the King and the Superstar, Lawler and Dundee, maybe with some baseball bats at hand, too, going against Eddie Gilbert, Hot Stuff, and Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony. This should be some kind of match. They have been going at each other for a couple of weeks now, and you talk about adding the Texas Tornado rules and the bunkhouse rules, and you got yourself quite a night. But don't forget that extra special stipulation. Tessa and the Dirty White Girl will both be handcuffed to Dirty White Boy Tom Burton, and Burton will be shackled to the ring so he can't run around all over the building. 8 o'clock, Monday night, Memphis Mid-South Coliseum. Hope to see you there, back here in just a moment. By the time they've had those belts. Tiger and Scott Braddock, his partner, they got Downtown Bruno in their corner. Looks like they're all ready. The crowd is ready. You can tell from listening to them. We're ready. And here we go. Jeff Gaylord shoulders down on the mat quickly. Joey Maggs, nice move. He hooks him down again in the small package. Used that jackknife to get him down there, but he couldn't make it stick for a three count. Maggs wasting no time going for the victory, but couldn't get it just yet. Bruno over here.
How's it feel to watch the tag team of the 90s? I'm talking about Jeff Gaylord, Scott Braddock, the Wild Thing, along with the greatest manager in history, Downtown Bruno. We're going all the way to the top. Every belt, every championship, I feel it in my blood. I feel it in my bones. USWA Tag Team Championship of the World coming to Downtown Bruno and the Wild Things, baby. It's like Mama says, it be that way sometimes.
It may be and it may not be. We'll see. Scott Braddock and Jeff Gaylord in there. The world tag titles are on the line right here today.
And they're taking it right to the champions. Braddock misses with that drop of that elbow, and Joey Maggs real quick to recover.
Joey Maggs, nice move. He used a fist, I think, but he nailed Scott Braddock and popped him back to the corner after Braddock was making a move on him. Here comes Rex King. And Rex and Joey put Scott Braddock down on the mat. They double up on the exchange on the tag.
Those Rex and Joey are so natural as a team, just watching them work in the ring, they just know each other's every move.
And that's the amazing thing. As you said, it took them such a short time to win those championship belts. How two guys can come in and work together as a team so well, so quickly. It's all chemistry is a word that's used sometimes in a situation like that, and I think that must be the case with Rex King and Joey Mag. Scott Braddock getting in a shot or two at Rex King. He hit him with a fist. He clotheslines him, and he flies through the air at him.
At the same time, you got to give credit to Scott Braddock and Jeff Gaylord. They have been getting better and better each week as they team together, and, of course, they've got the strength on their side.
They do indeed, and, of course, former professional football player and Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord. Gaylord played in the USFL. He was drafted by the Los Angeles Rams a couple of years ago, played in the USFL, and he's tough. He was a defensive tackle at Missouri, as I recall.
He was quite notorious for his antics, both on and off the field, both in college and in the pros.
Right.
He is that way also in his professional wrestling career, as you can tell by his actions in the ring right now.
I think Wild Thing is a pretty apt description of Mr. Gaylord. Gaylord and Braddock, a tough tag team, challenging for the USWA tag titles right here on Championship Wrestling today. Joey Maggs fired into the turnbuckles. Rex King working on Scott Braddock while Jeff Gaylord has Joey Maggs hanging upside down from the corner. And look out, Bruno is over there. You don't need that. Bruno encouraging Gaylord back in the corner.
Referee Jerry Calhoun's got his hands full right now. Maggs is caught. Look at Bruno.
Yeah, Bruno's holding Joey Maggs upside down in the corner while Scott Braddock kicks him in the midsection. Now Gaylord is saying, hey, come on over here. I've got Rex King. Hey,
look out.
What? No. Pile driver. Look out. Ken Wayne and Cowabunga got in there just in time as Gaylord looked like he was going for a pile driver on Rex King. And all of a sudden, Ken Wayne and Cowabunga jump in there. And they nail the Wild Thing. They've got a match coming up.
There's one for Bruno.
Oh! I kind of enjoyed seeing that myself as Bruno comes firing out of there. Look out!
Whoa!
Over here on the table.
Scott Braddock coming our way head first. Whoa!
Ken Wayne picks up that stool again and nails Scott Braddock in the top of the head. We got to take a quick break. We'll try to get this all settled. We'll be back with more in a moment. Stop that whole thing. So that's the way that one is. We are all out of time. Look for you next week on USWA Championship Wrestling. Good having you with us today, Michael St. John.
Dave, with you. Hope to be back with you soon.
Hope so too. Until next week, I'm Dave Brown. So long, everybody.
The announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of USWA Championship Wrestling.
USWA Championship Wrestling, Wednesday night, the Evansville Coliseum. Three great main events, including a Texas death match with bunkhouse rules, all four men in the ring. Jerry the King Lawler and superstar Bill Dundee with Tessa take on Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, with the Dirty White Girl in their corner, Tessa and the White Girl both handcuffed to Tom Burton. Opening action, Wild Thing Scott Braddock takes on the Galaxian. You'll see the USWA tag title, Southern Rocker Rex King and Hotshot Joey Maggs take on Don Harrison, Primetime Brian Lee. The $5,000 challenge match, Cowabunga the Karate Turtle meets the Missouri Tiger Jeff Gaylord with Downtown Bruno. the USWA Southern Heavyweight title on the line, Jeff Jarrett against Hollywood John Tatum, and then that big Texas Deathmatch main event, Lawler and Dundee with Tessa against Gilbert and Anthony with Dirty White Girl. Tessa and White Girl, both handcuffs to Tom Burton, Wednesday night in Evansville. And don't miss USWA Wrestling coming to KDS, Kentucky, Thursday, August 23rd, Trigg County High School. We'll see you Wednesday night in Evansville.
Hollywood John Tatum. That's right, you're the Southern Heavyweight Champion. And I've got a match coming to go up against you this week. It means a whole lot. It means a whole lot more than just winning the Southern title. And yeah, that is a great belt to hold because there's been a lot of great champions. Jerry Lawler, Bill Dundee, Jackie Fargo, the Greens, the list goes on and on and on. But John Tatum, when you're the Southern Heavyweight Champion, that means that you're one step away from the unified world heavyweight title. And John, I'm going to do everything I can to win that belt. I don't care if you want to wrestle, I'll wrestle you. If you want to fight, I'll fight you. But I know one thing, my ultimate dream, climbing up the staircase of professional wrestling, is to be the world heavyweight champion. And in this match, I'm going to get one step closer. So Hollywood John Tatum, you better get ready, because I'm coming after that belt with everything I got, and that's a promise.
It's USWA Championship Wrestling, Wednesday night, the Evansville Coliseum. Three great main events, including a Texas death match with bunkhouse rules, all four men in the ring. Jerry the King Lawler and superstar Bill Dundee with Tessa take on Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, with the Dirty White Girl in their corner. Tessa and the White Girl both handcuffed to Tom Burton. Opening action, Wild Thing Scott Braddock takes on the Galaxian. You'll see the USWA tag title, Southern Rocker Rex King and Hotshot Joey Mag take on Don Harris and Primetime Brian Lee. The $5,000 challenge match. Cowabunga, the Karate Turtle, meets the Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord, with Downtown Bruno. The USWA Southern Heavyweight title on the line, Jeff Jarrett against Hollywood John Tatum. And then that big Texas Deathmatch main event, Lawler and Dundee with Tessa against Gilbert and Anthony with Dirty White Girl. Tessa and White Girl, both handcuffed to Tom Burton, Wednesday night in Evansville. And don't miss USWA Wrestling coming to Cadiz, Kentucky, Thursday, August 23rd, Trigg County High School. We'll see you Wednesday night in Evansville. USWA Championship Wrestling, Wednesday night, the Evansville Coliseum. Three great main events, including a Texas death match with bunkhouse rules, all four men in the ring. Jerry the King Lawler and superstar Bill Dundee with Tessa take on Dirty White Boy Tony Anthony, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, with the Dirty White Girl in their corner. Tessa and the White Girl both handcuffed to Tom Burton. Opening action, Wild Thing Scott Braddock takes on the Galaxian. You'll see the USWA tag title, Southern Rocker Rex King and Hotshot Joey Mag take on Don Harris and Primetime Brian Lee. The $5,000 challenge match. Cowabunga, the Karate Turtle, meets the Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord, with Downtown Bruno. The USWA Southern Heavyweight title on the line, Jeff Jarrett against Hollywood John Tatum. And then that big Texas Deathmatch main event, Lawler and Dundee with Tessa against Gilbert and Anthony with Dirty White Girl. Tessa and White Girl, both handcuffed to Tom Burton, Wednesday night in Evansville. And don't miss
the USWA in your hometown. It's America's number one fundraiser, USWA Wrestling. The stars, the action, the excitement. USWA Wrestling. For more information on how you can raise money for your organization, write the USWA, Post Office Box 1783, Hendersonville, Tennessee, 37077, or call 615-824-8523. USWA Wrestling, America's number one fundraiser.
Let me tell you something, brother. Give me that microphone. Come on out here.
America.
You know what? What kind of a man comes out and attacks the Wild Things in downtown Bruno?
A yellow-bellied coward.
A yellow-bellied coward, that's right. Four on two. Now I'm a manager. I'm not even a wrestler. And they're both going to hit me, and they're going to hit the Wild Things from behind. I don't like it one single bit. If you're any kind of man, you're any kind of wrestlers, come out in our faces. The Wild Things don't back from any challenge, any time, any day, twice on Sunday. If you want some of the Wild Things, you come on and get the Wild Things in our faces. Sign it up. Don't jump us from behind, Dave. What, Dave? What?
You've had your say. The match is signed. The match is going to be coming up. We're out of time. You can stand here, rant, rave all day. Michael St. John, thanks for joining us. We'll see you next week. Bye, everybody.